supper and a mother at the best place around. Some stupid with a flare gun burned the place to the ground. Smoke on the water, fire in the sky. Smoke on the water.
This should be a very dynamite show.
You know, I have no idea what the name of this program is, but you're watching it.
Backstage.
All you ever want.
Backstage.
All you ever need.
Backstage.
Your dreams will be fulfilled once you are there. You'll never want to leave. You'll want to sell your ass for that backstage pass.
Backstage
is just for the invited.
Backstage,
they've laid on everything.
Hello, darlings. This is Rudy. It's again time for Rudy Backstage. You are in very bad company. And I say hello, still from a secret place, but maybe if you look exactly, could be maybe a different secret place or just another room at the secret place. Where am I? Where am I? Today we talk about three topics, or the content of my streaming are three topics. It's John Lennon, because we just had the 8th of December and 40 years of the dramatic day. We talk about John Deacon, the wonderful bass player of my favorite band, Queen. And of course, I'm updating you on my Freddie Mercury book. So still a little word on the secret place. Again, the secret place gives me a little bit of possibility to breathe. It will be bit by bit, be clearer and clearer where I am to certain regions. I can tell you one thing, to make it a little bit clearer. I am not in Miami, because some of the people have been writing, yeah, maybe just with Antonio was filmed. No, I'm not in Miami. I swear to God, I'm not in Miami. We're going to make a little Rudy on tour, where is he kind of world map. So they're still in the play Hawaii, diving with my son Benjamin. They're still in the play the Dominican Republic, because as you know, there I was not thinking and there was this towel in the back. Some of you zoomed in and saw it, Dominican Republic. I also would have to prepare something there for my new FICO, international version of my FICO film. And it could, of course, be Vienna, because the my favorite hotel, Ibis, in Vienna, well, actually in continental Europe, is sponsoring the streaming. But that could also be a money thing and have nothing to do. And it could also be the Czech Republic, because as you know, Peter Freestone, my best friend, and myself, we have not only a secret project, but also some other things to do. Well, I mean, maybe I'm adding a few to the speculation, because to saying it could be that it's none of those, you know? Think a little bit. Where was I last? Okay, I was in Miami. I said I'm not in Miami. I didn't say I'm not in the United States. Because some of you said, oh, he's short. I'm sure he's still in Florida. Well, I'm having t-shirts like that all the time. And also usually shorts. Yeah. So that doesn't say anything. I don't have it here. I wanted to show you. I'm also still having my helmet, and I'm using that everywhere when I go. So anyway, it still goes on. I'm still thinking of, and as you can see in the back, it's chaos wherever I am. There you can also see one of the pictures of my son, Ruby, who is, as always, thank you, Ruby, the technical coordinator of this streaming, as is Milan Satnik, so kind to edit this, as is Claire Go, so kind, and upload it and be a production supervisor from Australia. Milan Satnik in the Czech Republic. Maybe I'm very close to Milan. there is, of course, Beth Ford as the associate producer in Cleveland, Ohio. And my son Ruby and my other son Benjamin in Vienna. So, and am I in the secret place? So there's a lot of places involved. Anyway, darlings, John Lennon. I mean, we all basically agree that that John is one of the most influential musicians, songwriters, singer-songwriters, political activists there ever were, at least in my opinion. I had the privilege to do quite a few things, although the main thing that I remember is actually a big project which did not happen because he was murdered. This is a very personal thing again. I do remember the 8th of December, 40 years ago, because after many, many years of trying, I mean, don't forget, Freddie Mercury always said that his big idol in terms of writing lyrics is John Lennon, and he would never be in the same range in his, Freddie's eyes, as John Lennon is. And after I've worked with Paul McCartney in 1979, and George Martin, the famous Beatles producer, the Rolling Stones, of course, and many others, I was always trying to get an interview with John Lennon and do a documentary with him. And finally, the beginning of 1980, I got an okay, because I was doing at the time a program called Music Scene with my then partner, Hannes Olsacher. And that was sort of the most competent music television magazine in the German-speaking market, Germany, Austria, Switzerland. So it was also quite important for record sales. And that was when it was clear that Lennon would release another album called Double Fantasy together with Yoko Ono. And we managed to get on the list. There was only 10 interviews that he wanted to do for, and in each country, only one. And I was on the list. So when this horrible, horrible, horrible day came, where this, I have to say, deranged fan killed him in front of his apartment house in New York City, not only did the world lose one of the greatest writers and of pop history ever, I also lost the opportunity to do this interview, which I was one of my dreams, and it was clear it will never happen. So that was a very sad day, I remember. And I do also remember that I later had the privilege to work with Yoko Ono. I did do an interview many years later. She did a musical in New York City, which I was meant to film. Unfortunately, a very unsuccessful musical, but I was always a privilege, and I found Yoko Ono also because of her peace and her general engagement in things. Very, very interesting person. I also worked with Julian Lennon later, who is, as you know, the first son of John Lennon, but not the son of Yoko and John, which is Sheen. I never met him in person. But Yoko Ono is a very, very interesting woman and person, very, very great person. And I remember that well. The funniest story that I can tell you about John Lennon and Yoko Ono, which I witnessed, was in their apartment, actually. I didn't have a camera. I couldn't do anything. There was no phones at the time. Because there's two stories, actually. The one is, Yoko Ono was getting the groceries, tomatoes, apples, the groceries, you know, and was putting some of it in the fridge. And John Lennon went there and wanted to take a carrot, and Yoko said, "No, stop. I have to make a photograph. Don't forget, it's a piece of art." John Lennon was laughing. So she was everything, because she was a performance artist. She not only took a canvas and made a picture, for her was several things, which is actually a very good thing. And the other story, which I think is very funny, is, see, she wanted to have a fur coat, which is now not politically correct anymore, but we're talking late 70s. And of course, when John Lennon, the ex-Beatle, and Yoko Ono want the fur coat, you don't go into the shop of the fur coat. No, the shop comes to you home. So this apartment in Dakota Building was quite big. So there was dozens and dozens of fur coats hanging on hangers, and she was going through, and John Lennon was sitting there and was very bored. And she said, I don't know, maybe this. But what do you think, John? And John Lennon was super bored. And she says, "Yeah, I'm not sure. Which one should I take?" And after about an hour, John Lennon said, "Why don't you take them all? We have the money. Take them all." I found that very funny. So again, John Lennon, who, as I think, with the song Imagine, was doing a timeless masterpiece, which of course gets renewed and re-sang and re-recorded, very rightly so, because it is a masterpiece and a hymn and a legendary iconic song. I want to remember him also with funny stories and not be sad, although I have to say it's a big loss. And if you think now that it's already 40 years, and he could still be alive, what would he have done in those 40 years as an artist, as a human being, as a political activist? Don't forget, he was a peace activist, and it was really dangerous in America. He was doing bed-ins for peace when it was really provocative. So John Lennon and Yoko Ono are some very, very, very outstanding people. And I take my hat and say, John Lennon, I love you. Yoko Ono, I love you too. From one John to the other John, John Deacon. Now, there is always the cliches, you know, the John Deacon is the quiet, like there was the quiet Beatle, George Harrison. Well, if you knew George Harrison, he wasn't quiet at all. He was just in public, he didn't say as much as John Lennon and Paul McCartney. And so John Deacon was not necessarily the quiet one. He was just not so much interested in the fighting that was sometimes, well, quite some often sometimes, going on in control rooms. Sometimes I was allowed to film it. Other times I was allowed to be there and witness it. But it was he was somebody who wasn't so much interested in that. And that who would maybe say one sentence after half an hour, and it was dead right to the point. John Deacon is a very, very talented musician. His friendship to Freddie Mercury was very intense. And I remember a few things with John. Once, the first time that we did an extensive interview was for Magic Years. Was in the Pembridge Road Queen office at the time, which is not existing anymore, at the upper floor for Magic Years. And we did many other interviews around videos, etc. And the last time I met, well, I don't know which was first. There was the Freddie Mercury tribute concert, of course, where we met each other and talked to each other. And then there was the video shoot, which I remember as the last thing, but you look it up when it was, I don't remember. Everything that you can look up, I don't have to remember. I have to remember the important things. So when we were filming No One But You, Only the Good Die Young, where it was the only Queen song at the time, where Freddie Mercury was not singing, it was Brian May and Roger Taylor who were singing, excuse me, it's the water. We were talking a lot because I had the same crew as for the two previous videos, which I see as a trilogy, the last one was Freddie, Days of Our Lives, and the last really great one, which I think I'm going slightly mad. And John Lennon already told me then, in a quiet moment when nobody else was listening, that for him, Queen died when Freddie died. So, although it was not discussed at the time that Queen would go on with other singers, etc., that was not at all on the table. Don't forget, Roger Taylor said in an interview for my documentary of the Freddie Mercury tribute concert, Queen is over. Brian May said that after Freddie died, a year after Freddie died. So it was only later that through the project, which I think was an invention by Jim Beach, very clever, Queen Plus, where it was Queen Plus quite a few stars at the Freddie Mercury tribute, and then later the Queen Plus Paul Rogers, which I think was still a very legitimate lineup, that the idea came, well, is there a life of Queen after Freddie? And as you now know, with Adam Lambert, they're selling more records than ever, or at least in the same amount. That's one criteria that you can look at the success of a band. And I'm very happy that Roger and Brian are happy and still touring and doing all that. But it might be allowed that people think, like John Deacon does, that the real Queen had Freddie Mercury as the singer. That's also a legitimate point. And I can understand both sides. I wouldn't say I'm in the middle, but it's not so important what I think. Everybody knows that Freddie and I were very close and that I enjoyed the work. And you can look up what I've done. But John, to me, is a very, very underrated musician. It's a pity that he doesn't do a lot after Queen, because I do remember he was doing some film score music, because when there was once the idea that I do the solo work of the four of them, and Freddie had a solo album, Roger already had two before Freddie, Brian was doing solo work, actually then also a solo tour, as you know. The only thing that John did was he took part in a film music score and was part of a video, so that was the only thing that we could come up with. That's a little bit of pity, because I think he's a very talented musician and composer. I mean, for example, Friends Will Be Friends, my second video, the first one that I had the privilege to direct in London, which also is sort of the theme song of my book, My Friend Freddie, is written by John Deacon and Freddie Mercury together. And I think, and John and Deacon told me at the time, that the reason why he's not part of the other Queen, or the new Queen after Freddie, is because he loves Freddie so much. I really think that. That's why I think that everybody should respect that. And I think a lot of people do. So Deacon will maybe probably be the center of a documentary that I do, because there's a lot of interesting things about John Deacon which are rarely said. He also didn't give a lot of interviews. I was able to do quite a few, but that is something which maybe is still on the list. Don't forget, my plan is that I'm still doing 10 more films. That's it. 10. But I already know what the next book is after Freddie. I mean, first of all, we have to bring that out, but the next book is definitely the one about my life, the autobiography. And I'm eager to start, although, first of all, let's get to Freddie. Which brings me to the Freddie book and to something very important. I have news. First of all, I repeat, due to coronavirus, the release is delayed, but also due to new great ideas of my publisher, of other people involved. The Freddie Mercury book, My Friend Freddie, which I aim to be the Freddie Mercury book, not a Freddie Mercury book. The plan is now that it's released in 11 languages worldwide on the very fucking same day. That's what Freddie would like. And that's why I had to break my word where I said the German and the English version will be released in 2020, also due to Corona. Because a lot of the pre-things that were planned for summer, they were all cancelled. So there is like a two-year plan with my book, which is pre-release parties, pre-release readings around the world, then the actual release, then a book tour, and then a stage project, which is in connection with my book. I'm not saying more, but that's a two-year plan. And this had to be moved back, basically because of Corona. And I'm saying now the following things. Please, it's not going on for a long time, but do it. And if you have done it, persuade your friends or your family. It's going to be the super deal of your life. Pre-order my book, My Friend Freddie, in www.myfriendfreddy.com. I repeat, www.myfriendfreddy.com. Because for the following reasons, you'll be the first ones to get the book before it's in shops, before it's on Amazon or anywhere else. It's the only way you get an autographed book. Not only that, you also can get a dedication and choose the dedication. That's all for $10, respectively $15, which is only €8 or €13. It's literally nothing. But not only that, you will also get a code, and everybody who has pre-ordered will get that code. And with that code, starting in January, I will do readings in German, English, and French of chapters. Not the foreword, we know that, I've done that already. But of chapters, exclusively to those who were so kind and pre-order my book. Not only that, you will also get a golden backstage pass, which will then on the book tour give you a meet and greet with me personally and a photo opportunity. So think about it. For $10, as the Americans say, 10 bucks, that's a super deal, and it is going to be limited very soon. And it is, if you have it already, the perfect Christmas gift. The perfect Christmas gift to a friend or to family or to somebody you like or love. So not only that, there is some more news regarding the book, because I also made, as you know, the decision that there will be three covers. And you, the fans, will choose. And the covers that are voted by the fans will be the cover. So that this book is also becomes your book. And I also know exactly the covers will be out soon for voting. And not only that, in February, around my birthday, if Corona allows it, I will do the world premiere of a physical reading, not the streaming that's from January, but where I actually sit. And I want you to now send me in which place should this reading be? Miami, New York, Los Angeles, Vienna, Prague, Madrid, Paris, Moscow, Tokyo, etc. Let's do a voting, and every vote counts. Everybody can only vote once. Where should this one-off world premiere reading, which later will be a tour, but the one-off is in February, up front to the release. Where, in which city should it be? Isn't that always with Backstage, there is something new. Okay, darlings, you know that the backstages of The Secret Place, and I still call it Secret Place, are limited in time. I say thank you for your attention. Please, as you know, Rudy Backstage is on IGTV. It's on Facebook, Rudy Dorletzer Official. It's also in various Facebook groups who take it. It's in the meantime tens of thousands of viewers. And it's also on YouTube. And on YouTube, we have what we call the Backstage Experience. It's a group of people, quite a lot, getting bigger and bigger, that meet every Sunday at the original time, which way you ever want to see it, in 7 p.m. in London, 8 p.m. in most of Europe, 9 p.m. if I'm not mistaken in Moscow and other parts of Europe, 2 p.m. in Miami, 11 a.m. in Los Angeles, in Australia and Japan is then already on Monday. And at this time, which is always the same, that's the original Rudy Backstage time and it was a live streaming, there will always be the live chat, which means you're part of this and you can ask me and everybody gets a personalized answer. That's also quite nice for fans, because I hold it with Freddie Mercury, he said, without fans, we are nothing. And Rudy Dorletzer says this too. And I say thank you for being my guest. And you know my three wishes. I mean, the first thing is, by the way, Sharon Deseret is almost done with the friendship certificates. So go to Rudy Dorletzer's Doro TV, like it and subscribe it. There is already more than 2,500, so the gold certificates are over. But now I give out for everybody who subscribes to my channel a silver friendship certificate, which is also nice and will have other bonuses. The gold ones, as you know, also get a golden backstage pass and to my reading book tour whenever that happens after Corona is over. And so please subscribe to my channel. Please pre-order my book. I please ask you and remind you it's a very, very good Christmas gift. And then please never, never. Please, never, never. I know I'm bad company, but never, 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 never. Please miss a Sunday when it's again Rudy Backstage. And I say thank you so much. And it's time for Dana Gillespie with her great voice singing the Backstage song. Love and respect. Stay safe. Go and test yourself wherever you are. And you have to get the vaccination when it's out. Only if we all get vaccinated, we can get rid of that fucking virus. If not 70% of the population is immune, either by having had it and being immune, not everybody is immune who had it, or by getting vaccinated, this will go on and on and on and on. And people will lose jobs and shop will have to close and people will not know how to put food on the table. So when the fuck the the vaccination is here and it's safe, if Dr. Fauci in America and other people in Europe say it's safe, go and get fucking vaccinated. Because I do it for you. And everybody has to do it for the other. And if all people are doing it for the other person, then somebody also does it for me. But in our society where it's me, I, we have to think of the other people because otherwise we are fucked. Mwah! I love you.
Darlings, until this day, Freddie is the person in all my life that influenced me the most. My mentor, my hero, my friend. This book tells it all. Easy love, but you got friends, you get drunk. Freddie was a special person, and I felt very privileged to call him my friend and to work with him and Queen. This book tells it all.
Goes on backstage. Oh, come on. Let me take you by the hand. Ow!
Rudy, are you ready?
Ladies and gentlemen!
The way I see it, Barry, this should be a very dynamite show.
You know, I have no idea what the name of this program is, but you're watching it.
Backstage.
All you ever want.
Backstage.
All you ever need.
Backstage.
Your dreams will be fulfilled once you are there. You'll never wanna leave. You'll wanna sell your ass for that backstage pass.
Backstage.
It's just for the invited.